To start a very simple topic that is cell cycle and cell division. Okay, for grade 12 2021 batch, it is already done, right? And the student who are there in 2022 batch, for them also this topic is done. We are quickly revising this topic. Okay, so first of all, before starting the topic, see the actual weightage of this topic in the NEET. Though it is very small topic, very simple topic, to first on this topic, that is a cell cycle and cell division, the one question is there, definitely 101% the question will be asked from cell cycle and cell division. Okay, so this topic has total 8 marks, 2 questions means weightage only 4%. See, and that mark is important as per the score point of view, right? As compared to, or as you talk about this topic, that's very easy. So let's study this topic in detail. Okay, already you studied it. For better understanding, you need to read the content. Okay, take a screenshot of it for your understanding. Okay, take a screenshot of it for your understanding, for your study. Topic is of question will be asked on it. One question is there on the cell. If you go through the question, or if you go to the question paper, previous year PYQ's questions, yes, tell the unit life. It has a more weightage, but here we are talking about the cell cycle and cell division, the single. So there are 10 topics, Mohsam, right? In the studying the NEET, there are 10 topics. Out of in that 10 units, 35 topics are there, and out of that there is one subtopic from the cell, the unit of life. Okay, so on this topic, particularly on this topic, only 2 questions will be asked, but that 2 questions will give you 8 marks, which point of view very important. So take a screenshot of your understanding. So let's start with the topic. First, 4 main points from this topic here. Content at a glance, you're observing a 6 points. So first one, cell cycle, cell division, mitosis, meiosis, and last one, significance of mitosis and meiosis. Today we are going to study cell cycle, cell division, mitosis, significance of mitosis. So first one, mitosis before it cell. Will you please tell me what is cell? Here you are observing a 3 different diagram where you are observing a dividing cell. Okay, there are 3 diagrams which are, so it shows an dividing cell. What is cell? Yes, what is cell? Yes, it is the building block of, it is the building block of life, right? Different cells. Okay. Body is made up of a different cell. So for growth and reproduction, that cell, it undergoes a several division, right? It's a unit of life, right, Ganesh? The basic and fundamental unit of life is said to be a cell. For its growth and reproduction, every organism or every living organism or that cell, it undergoes the division, and that cell, it gets enlarged. So diagram where you are observing a division of a cell, a single cell is divided to form a 2 daughter cell, 2 from here. It results in reproduction, means cell which undergoes the process of division is responsible for growth and reproduction. Enlargement means what? Growth and reproduction. See, a single cell divides into a 2 cell. That 2 cell again divides into a 4 cell. That 4 cell itself undergoes the division, and from that core cell we are getting 16 different cells. And in third diagram, you are observing a two cell, how they are exchanging their genetic material. Okay. This division mechanism for multiplication of cells, which together responsible for the reproduction. So ultimately, cell division is responsible for what? Cell division is responsible for production of the cell, that is the reproduction of the cell. Okay, here the word it is the reproduction of the cell, production of a new cell. So this is about the cell. Now this cell, it undergoes a series or sequential event in its life. So that series or sequential event which occurs in the life of a dividing cell is said to be a cell cycle. So here the definition of cell cycle is that, what is cell cycle? Up to the point cell, its function, is it clear? Cell is a basic structural functional unit of life. Our body is made up of trillion cells. This cell daily, means in a day, within a minute, within a second, they are undergoing the process of a division for what? For growth and reproduction. The main purpose is a growth and reproduction of the cell. For that purpose, that cell undergoes a sequential event. Sequential event means the events which occur one after the other. So it undergoes the sequential events. So that sequential event is said to be a cell cycle. Already you studied it, so this is a revision point of view, it is important. Okay, so here on the screen you are observing the diagram of the cell cycle, right? Cell cycle, basically it is divided into two phases. So which are these two main phases of cell cycle? Are you getting the point? Cell cycle, the series of event which is occur in a life of a dividing cell, is what is a cell cycle. We are growing, the cells are reproducing. So that reproduction, their growth is taking place by a sequential event. One after other, the events are taking place and then the new cells are formed. So it undergoes or it includes two main steps. First one is interphase and second one M phase. What is the interphase? In the diagram, you're observing that interphase, then the M does not mean only the mitosis. It also means the meiosis, right? So what do you know about the interphase? What exactly the changes is there in the interphase? Yes. Which changes you are observing in the interphase? See, there are many points that we are going to discuss. So be fast, be quick. Because after that, we are studying division, then its type. With the diagram, we are explaining it. Then each step in detail, we are going to study. That cell, it grows. Is it only the correct answer? It's absolutely correct. The cell, they are growing. But what exactly it is there in the interphase? Okay, so see, in interphase, cell is preparing itself for the division. What is there in the interphase? Cell is preparing itself for division. Yes, it is said to be a resting phase. Okay, it is said to be a resting phase. Resting phase means it itself prepare itself for the process of division. The first phase of cell cycle, it is quite longer. Why it is long? Because before or after the birth, they are preparing themselves. So it is divided into three main stages, sub stages, S phase and G2 phase. So here two that symbols are you're observing, G1 and S. What the word G represents and what the word S represents. You need to read this topic in detail. The only two questions are asked. See, one question it is there on the cell cycle. It is based on the thing that is there in front of your screen. Yes, S stands for synthesis and G stands for gap. So gap one phase, S phase and G two phase. So let's study it. So here on the screen, okay, a single cell which is divided into two different cells. Two different cells you are observing here. Okay. So see here, you are observing the cell. The two cells are there, but out of which what you are observing, one cell it is there, it is does not undergoing any changes. So that cell, it remains non-functional. Okay, that cell, it remains non-functional means they are living at the or staying at the Z0 stage. They are not performing any function. They are functionless. So that cell does not further show the growth. Such cells are responsible for causing the cancer. But rest of the cells are there. That cell, it undergoes the process of division. Okay, so or growth. So here you are observing this cell. These are starting its phase. Okay, so in G1 phase, in gap 1 phase, what exactly the changes in the cell that you are observing? What changes you are observing in G1 phase? Yes. What things, what events are occurred in the G1 phase? Like it is given, the chromosome starts to get duplicate. Duplication of chromosome is there in the gap 1 phase or G1 phase, right? Which other changes you are observing in the G1 phase, which cell organelles they start to develop? Which cell organelles it starts to develop? Is DNA start to develop in the G1 phase? RNA starts to develop in the G1 phase, nucleolus, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosome. If all the cell organelles are starts to develop, yes, okay, then what exactly or which events exactly taking place in the G1 phase? Are you getting the thing? See, we are discussing one of the important topic which is very easy. We'll get 8 marks easily if you study it or if you understand the topic by heart. Yes. Replication of a DNA is taking place, duplication of a chromosome, and the second one, synthesis of protein is taking place in this phase. Cell, it becomes metabolically active. Metabolically active means it performs various processes, like if it is performing the respiration, whatever the other metabolic processes are there. Okay. Cellular respiration, suppose the digestion, production of a different substance. So metabolically, it is active. Second thing, the cell, it starts to increase their size. As the different metabolic activities are going inside it, automatically the cell gets enlarges. So in G1 phase, this is the initial phase where duplication of a DNA is taking place. Cell, it gets metabolically active and cell, it enlarges in size. If such changes are not observed in the cell, it remains at the G0 stage. It will be an arresting of the growth. That cell is responsible for causing the cancer as it stops the growth or the division of the other cell. So such cells get accumulated and it forms the tumor. And tumor ultimately results in the formation of a cancer. Okay, so here the cell, it completed the G1 stage, right? As it becomes metabolically active, as there is an increase in size, it undergoes the second, right? So that phase is said to be a S phase. Already we discussed it, that is a synthesis phase. Since production, which substance are produced in S phase? Here the process of duplication of the replicated chromosome is stopped. Then which substance it is synthesized in the S phase? Though it takes more time, but it is performing a very simple, right? Replication of a DNA. Production of exact copy of a DNA. DNA becomes more and more. Replication of a DNA is there in this phase. In yes phase. Only this single changes you are observing here. Yes, centrosomes again replicate. This is the part of the chromosome. Centrosomes again get replicated. ओके जीनोम, हियर द वर्ड इट इज देयर जीनोम. तो एनी स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम ग्रेड, इट्स रियली सिंपल, वी स्टडीड इट इन द टॉपिक मॉलिक्यूलर बेसिस ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस. इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर हिस्टोन सिंथेसिस. तो माय क्वेश्चन, व्हाट जीनोम? You're taking lot of time. So see, genome is what? A group of genes. The single gene, it perform a single function, but there are some genes which are representing themselves in the group. So group gene are said, yes, right, organism complete or set of a DNA. Or group of gene, they are said to be a genome. Okay, another point that Shweta told us to, that replication of histone is also there. So histone is a special kind of protein. That protein is responsible for binding the DNA. As DNA is a negatively charged, bind that DNA, histone proteins are important. So here the S phase is over. Third in the next phase, that is said to be a G0 stage. So here you are observing, it's a G0 stage. This is said to be a final stage where cell is prepare itself for the division. The growth which is required for the division, it is acquired by that cell. It is ready for the division. So these three phases are there, G1, S and G2 phase, right? After that, an interesting, important, and the phase which showing the drastic change in cell is M phase, okay? The second phase is the M phase, which is divided into two sub phases, that is mitosis and meiosis. But along with the mitosis and meiosis, M phase includes one type that is said to be a mitosis. So up to this, if it is cleared, we will discussing the next one. Up to this, it is clear. So let's study the next point, cell division. Okay, how you define the term cell division? Yes, what is cell division? Yes, what is cell division? So the definition is there in front of you. A process in which a parent cell, it divides to form a two equal cells. Yes, it is the replication of a cell. Cell, it forms exact copy of it, right? In short, you may say that it is the process of cell. Cell itself forms another replica of it in another exact copy of it. The division of a parent cell, here your parent cell, okay? See, mitosis and meiosis, the two different cells are observing over here, right? So these are said to be a parent cell, right? So here, this side, mitosis and meiosis, so parent cells, they divide to form two equal cells. Two daughter cells are formed. Mitosis is the result in the formation of only two daughter cells. In meiosis, we are getting four haploid daughter cells. So here you are observing four daughter cells and here you are observing two daughter cells, right? So before studying the mitosis and meiosis, cell division, basically it is of three main types: a mitosis, mitosis and meiosis. So do you know what is a mitosis? What is a mitosis? Yes. What is a mitosis? Anyone from you, what is a mitosis? Which is mostly observed in Paramecium and Amoeba. The organisms are unicellular, right? A single cell organisms are there, so that स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ डिवीजन फॉर स्पेशली फॉर द सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन और फॉर द रिप्रोडक्शन ऑकर्ड इन एन यूनिसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म आर सेड टू बी अ माइटोसिस राइट इट इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ यूनिसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म ओके अ माइटोसिस इज ऑब्जर्व्ड इन पैरामोशियम अमीबा आर यू सिंगल सेल बॉडी इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम पेरेंट वी आर गेटिंग अ टू डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिज्म दिस आर मीन फॉर द रिप्रोडक्शन ओके दे आर नॉट रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द ग्रोथ दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द रिप्रोडक्शन नाउ द टू मेन माइटोसिस एंड मियोसिस विल यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द बिग डिफरेंस बिटवीन द माइटोसिस एंड मियोसिस इन फ्रंट ऑफ द स्क्रीन ओके यू आर ऑब्जर्विंग दिस डायग्राम माइटोसिस ऑन the screen on the right side diagram of mitosis is there on the left side the diagram of meiosis are there what is the difference between the mitosis and meiosis Right, it's a stem cell, not a stem cell. It occurs in the somatic cell. Yes, mitosis is N to 2N, but meiosis is 2N to N. Right, and meiosis, it occurs in the germ cell, right? At the maturity, the organism shows, right, it is occurring in the germ cells or reproductive cells. Okay, so from that diagram, it is clear that parents divide to form. After the replication, it forms. In case of a mitosis, we are getting a four daughter cell, which are haploid. And in case of a mitosis, two diploid cells are formed. Two diploid cells are formed. Okay. So moving to the next point, mitosis. Mitosis is also said to be a equationally division. Before that, tell me, what do you mean by mitosis? What do you mean by the term mitosis? What is mitosis? Cells to form two equal daughter cells are said to be a mitosis. Mitosis is said to be an equationally division. Why it is said to be an equationally division? Yes. Why mitosis is said to be an equationally division? Mitosis is said to be an equationally division. Why it's so? Why it is said to be a division? Yes. As I already told you, there are many points to discuss. Even we are going to all the PYQs. The last session we solved almost 25 MCQs. I hope for this topic at least we solved 30. Why it is said to be equational division? So see, whatever the division of the cell it is there, it is responsible to form equal cell. The chromosome number, okay, it remains constant in the mitosis. So that is the equational division. Whatever the division it is taking place, the cell, it divides equally. From diploid cells, we are getting diploid. Another name for it, that is, it is also said to be a somatic cell division. Why it is said to be a somatic cell division? Because mostly the somatic parts of the body, they are undergoing the process of mitosis. So which are the somatic parts? The vegetative part. So mitosis is mostly observed in the vegetative part. So that's why it is okay. If this two sentence or the meaning of these two words are equational division and somatic cell division, yes, is it clear? Okay, so moving to the next point, mitosis is four main phases. these phases are prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. Which are these four main phases? Prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. In case of a prophase, so see here you are observing in chromosome, it starts to condense, right? Chromatin material, they get disintegrated. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus, it starts to disappear. In metaphase, all the chromosomes arrange themselves on the equal line. Anaphase refer as the shortest phase. Here, all the chromosomes, they start to move towards the opposite pole. So sister chromatids, they start to move towards the opposite pole. And in case of a telophase, a two individual cells are formed, right? A two individual cells are formed. So the changes you are observing in this phase, right? In metaphase, here the equatorial plate are there. So metameric plates are there where all chromosomes are arranged themselves on that plate. Then in case of an anaphase, see here, you are observing that is the chromosome due to the stain. Due to the stain which is used in the chromatin for the cytological study, that's why the chromosome, it appears pinkish in color. That pink color structure is a chromosome. That chromosomes, they are moving towards the opposite pole. And next step, as the chromosome, they move towards the opposite pole, two independent cells start to develop. So here, the round structure that you're observing, that these are what? These are the two independent cells. So from a single cell, two new cells are formed in mitosis. So these four stages are there. So let's study this four cells in detail. Okay. So first of all, prophase. Okay. So see here, this is the first phase. So pro means early. Okay. So prophase, the first phase of the cell division, it shows, or it is divided into two main phases, early prophase and late prophase. Okay. Two different phases are there. In the prophase, the phases are there. Early prophase and late prophase. The events that occur in this prophase are, so see here, before starting the event, see the structure inside the nucleus. So here on the green color structure that you are observing, it's a structure of a nucleus or structure of a cell. Okay. Here, this is the cell. Inside that cell, a different cell organelles are there. Here we are talking about only the nucleolus, then the mitotic spindle and the microtubules. Microtubules is cell organelles. Okay. So what changes is occurred in the cell when the cell, it is at the prophase. So whatever the yellow color mark you're observing here, that is a nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane is a protective membrane which gives protection to the nucleolus and the chromatin material which is present inside the cell. Here inside it, you're observing a black color structure that is said to be a chromosome. So pair of chromosomes, they are present over there. In the center that you're observing, a pinkish color structure, it is there. That is said to be a centromere. This centromere, it attaches with the kinetochore. So two different sister chromatids, they are attached with it. Okay. Here, these are the two parts. That is a mitotic spindle, which are separating this centromere. Okay. And the thread-like structure at the center you're observing, this is the microtubule, which is responsible for development of astral rays. Okay. So this is what, this is the structure of the cell in at the time of a division. Okay. Now see the events which is taking place during the prophase. The sequential event, that first one, the chromosome start to get condensed. Okay. Condensation of chromosome 8 occurs. What do you mean by the word condensation? So here at the center, you're observing the chromosome. So basically, a chromatin thread. So here, see here, the structure you're observing. This is what, this is said to be a chromatin thread. So this chromatin thread are very thin. Okay. Very thin and decondensed structure. But when cell, it completes these two phases, it starts to get condensed. Condensed means it becomes thick. Each chromosome, it becomes thick that chromosome it become condensed and short. The first point is clear. In the first stage, the chromosome, the thin and long chromosome, it becomes short and condensed. Second one, the spindle apparatus assemblage. Spindle apparatus means here the part that you are observing. So as soon as the nuclear envelope, the nucleus and nuclear membrane, right? So nuclear membrane and nucleolus, as it disappeared, this spindle apparatus, it starts to get assembled. It starts to form over there. Whatever the centrioles are there. So here this part at the center, this centrioles, it starts to move toward the opposite pole. So this is one pole. This is another pole. So this centriole, it starts to move towards the opposite pole. They are forming this mitotic fibers or spindle fibers in them. So the third point, centrioles, they start to move to the opposite pole, forming the spindle apparatus. The thread-like structure that you are observing like this, right? So that is nothing but the spindle apparatus. Okay. It starts to develop over here. And there is a formation of an astral or radial ray. These arrays are formed due to the activity of the microtubules. Okay, it is microtubules are only formed in the animals. It is not there in the plant. Okay, as all these changes are taking place, then the nuclear envelope disappears. Okay, so here the nuclear envelope totally get disappeared. The chromosomes, they arranged on this spindle fiber. Okay, getting it about the prophase. In simple words, in prophase, nuclear membrane, nucleolus get disappear, chromosome they become condensed, centrioles arrange themselves on the opposite pole, astral rays are formed in them. In that astral rays, especially in case of animals, they are developed from the microtubules. Astral rays are not there in plants. They are not developed from microtubules in case of plants. And finally, as all these changes are taking place, nuclear envelope get disappear. Getting the first stage. Yes. If any doubt it is there, you may ask. I'm moving to the next one, metaphase. Okay, the second stage, metaphase. So meaning of meta means middle. Middle phase. It's not said to be a middle phase. It's not a middle phase. Phase, chromosomes arrange themselves on the equator. Equatorial plate means the central region. Okay, chromosomes arrange themselves on the central region. So here, see the structure of cell. Okay, structure of cell, and inside it, the chromosomes are there. So here in the second diagram, see, second diagram, at the center, you're observing this chromosome. See the position of the chromosome. These chromosomes are completely there on the center. So here with the blue color structure, the chromosomes you are observing, this all the chromosomes align themselves on the metaphase plate. Okay. Yes, is there any doubt? In this phase, the simple thing is that whatever the chromosomes are there, they get paired, and this paired chromosomes arrange themselves on the equatorial plate. Meta means middle, chromosomes cells on the and imaginary plane. It is an sequential event occurs on that cell as the chromosomes are formed, right? Getting it? Okay, getting the second step, metaphase. Arrangement of the chromosomes on the equatorial plate. Then the cell enters into the next phase, that is said to be an anaphase. Anaphase is said to be a shortest phase. Okay, what is the anaphase? Ana means away. So chromosome starts to move away from the centromere or centriole. So whatever the chromatids are there, that sister chromatids, they get
फिर
यूजुअली टिल द मेटाफेज द क्रोमोसोम्स आर देयर इन द पेयर. सो हियर इन दिस फेज द पेयर्ड क्रोमोसोम दे गेट सेपरेट टू फॉर्म और द टू डिफरेंट क्रोमोसोम दे गेट सेपरेट. सो हियर दिस इज द जस्ट 1 मिनट. This is the diagram, the which is directly taken from the microscope. Okay, this is the structure which are observed in under the microscope. So the, in this here you are also observing that the chromosome they starts to move toward the opposite pole. Here, the animated picture of the chromosome it is given. So here, what changes or the structure that you are observing? The chromosomes are moving toward the opposite pole with the help of a centriole. So see here the yellow color portion you are observing, that is a centromere. So that centromere, they are facing towards the centriole and they starts to move. Means centrioles, it attracts the centromere. The yellow structure you are observing here, see this is the yellow color part present at the middle part of the chromosome, that is said to be a centromere. Okay. Each chromosome has a centromere. Centriole, this part is there. That centriole, it pulls that centromere towards itself. So half of the chromosome get attracted the one centriole, another opposite pole of it. So the movement or moving of the chromosome, it is taking place in anaphase. So here centromere gets slits and sister chromatids start to move towards the opposite pole. Okay, so shortest phase anaphase, where the chromosome they starts to move towards the opposite pole. Getting up to it. Now the next stage, last stage. So as two different cells are there, they are or the chromosome they starts to move towards the opposite pole. Centriole, it starts to develop the nuclear membrane and nucleolus. As nuclear membrane and nucleolus start to develop around the chromosome, okay, the chromosomes are situated at the center. So they start to develop chromatin thread from that chromosome. As the chromosome, they get decondensed. Whatever the thick chromosomes are there, they are converted to a thin chromosome. So in case of a telophase, the events which are occurred, that is, spindle apparatus disassemblage. Disassemblage means they get contracted. Okay, nuclear envelope, they are reformed by taking the set of sister chromatids. Suppose 16 chromosomes are there, 8 chromosomes they are moving toward the one pole and 8 chromosomes they are moving toward the opposite pole, right? So they, that set of sister chromatids, they form the assemblage and they form one nuclear membrane with a nucleolus, right? Again, the thick chromosomes, they start to uncoil, nucleolus reappears, nucleus again reappears, two individual cells are formed from it. So that is the end of the mitosis. Okay, so these four phases are there. There are many students, they yet confused about the meiosis and mitosis, exactly the stages which are there in mitosis and meiosis. Now, is it clear to you the four stages? Yes. Now, the four stages are clear to you. Stages are clear to you. Okay. If any doubt it is there, you may ask. Further, let's study the last point, the significance, cytokinesis. Okay. As soon as the cell, it completes the, as soon as the cell, it enters into the telophase, it starts the process of cytokinesis. Okay, cytokinesis means what? It is a division of a cytoplasm for, which results in the formation of a two daughter cell. Telophase is not the end of the mitosis. It forms or it undergoes the cytokinesis division of a cytoplasm to form the two daughter cell. It starts when the cell it is there in the phase. It it is responsible for cleave the two different cells. Cleave means is making compartment. Okay, so up to this part, okay, up to this part, what you are observing, see here, two different cells are there. Here, this is the one cell, this is another cell. Is it yet divided into two equal parts? Is it equally divided into two parts in the telophase? No, you are not observing a two individual cells. इथून दोन सेल झालेला तुम्हाला पाहायला मिळत आहेत का? नो, हियर द टू न्यूक्लियस आर देयर, दे आर इन द सेम सेल ओनली. सो ऍज द सेल इज एंटर इन टू द टेलोफेज, इट ऑल्सो फॉलो द अनदर प्रोसेस, दॅट इज द साइटोकायनेसिस. सो द ऍक्च्युअल सेपरेशन ऑफ दॅट सेल इट इज टेकिंग प्लेस थ्रू द साइटोकायनेसिस, द डिव्हिजन ऑफ द सेल और डिव्हिजन ऑफ द साइटोप्लाझम, विच रिझल्ट इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ टू डॉटर सेल. सो in the telophase itself only the process it starts, the cell, it cleaves into two parts. Okay, it cleaves means divide. See here, the division it is taking place into two parts. So cleavage of the cell into two equal halves it is taking place, right? Getting it, cytokinesis is one of the part of the mitosis, even meiosis. The cells get separate, two individual cells are formed from, if you talk about the animal cell, contraction of actin filament produce a cleavage filament or cleavage furrow. So here you are observing the cleavage furrow. So actin filament, what is actin? Yes, actin filament is the part of which cell organelle? Actin is the part of which cell organelle? Last 2 to 3 minutes are left. Actin, these are the part of microtubules, and microtubules are only present in animals, right? So from that microtubules, the actin filaments are there and they produce the cleavage furrow. So here you are observing this cleavage furrow. Okay, cleavage furrow. But in case of a plant cell, the cell plate forms between the nuclei. Okay, whatever the nucleus it is there, in that case the cell plate is formed. So this is the end of the mitosis, cytokinesis, and the first stage is said to be a karyokinesis, means cell division. It occurs in two cell stage, that is a karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Karyokinesis is divided into four phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. At the end of the telophase, means when the cell enters into the telophase, the process of cytokinesis it begins. Cytokinesis means division of a cytoplasm. Up to this point, okay, up to telophase, this is the division of the nucleus, right? This is the division of nucleus. Okay, the two nucleus, they are divided, but at the cell it enters into the telophase, it forms the cytokinesis, the cytoplasm gets separated. So this is the cell, it enters into the cytokinesis. Is it clear? So here it is the end of mitosis. So let's study it. What is the significance of mitosis? So mitosis is responsible for producing the daughter cell with identical genome. Identical genome means a group of genes due to which the same chromosome number is maintained. The diploid set of chromosome number is maintained. It restores the nucleocytoplasmic ratio. Nucleocytoplasmic ratio means whatever the content of the nucleoplasm and cytoplasm it is there, it maintains. It is equally distributed so that the proper cell growth is there, and it helps in the repair and replacement of the old and worn out cell. Okay, these are what? These are the significance of mitosis. If you know any other significance of it, you may tell it to me. Okay. So these are the main, the basic significance of mitosis. Is it clear? Is this point mitosis is clear? I will share this PPT on the group for your understanding. Most of you are there, okay? But reading the content is more important. Today only you got the notification that your exams are going to be held. Even the competitive exams are there. You are not having option for that. This have to 2021 batch. You need to study hard for better score. You are having a chance to score more. And these are some effective sessions through which you are getting more and more things. Rest of the things are there, that is in your hand, to read the content, to practice the question, ask the doubts. Okay. Hope the things are very clear to you. For better understanding, read the content and ask the maximum doubt. Okay. If any other doubt it is there, you may ask. No other, we will stop for today's session. Yes. Okay, we will stop for today's session. Thank you all of you for attending.